चैतन्यमयी सत्यमयी परमी। ओम श्री अरविंदो मीरा इज माय रिफ्यूज। नमस्ते, वंदे मातरम, गुड इवनिंग, वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे दिस इवनिंग विल डिस्कस ऑन रेमिनिसेंसेस ऑफ द गोल्डन डे। वेरी शॉर्ट डिस्कशन, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डिस्कशन। सो रेमिनिसेंसेस ऑफ द गोल्डन डे, द टॉपिक ऑफ दिस इवनिंग्स डिस्कशन टुडे। सो वी नो द सुपरमेंटल मैनिफेस्टेशन एंड द फर्स्ट एनिवर्सरी, इट फेल्ट ऑन 29th February 1960। सो रिगार्डिंग दिस फोर्स, द सेलिब्रेशन, द ऑब्जर्वेशन एंड द रेमिनिसेंसेस, ऑफ कोर्स वी आर गोइंग टू टेक अप इन ब्रीफ दिस इवनिंग। सो लेट अस टेक दिमोन भाई सम एग्जाम्पल, हिज लेट अस कोट हिम फर्स्ट। बट बिफोर गोइंग फॉर दिस थिंग डिस्कशन, बेटर टू टेक वन एग्जाम्पल, वन ब्यूटिफुल मेसेज गिवेन बाई मदर, वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग न्यूज। ऑफकोर्स इट इज सुप्रामेंटल मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑन अर्थ। Regarding that, mother has a very nice message, two nice messages we have seen, previously we have seen. The supramental world exists permanently and I am there permanently in a supramental body. So this is her observation and this is her, of course, confidently she says the truth, she assures the truth. The supramental world exists permanently, I am there, and I am there permanently in a supramental body. So second quotation, second message from mother, Sri Aurobindo came upon the earth from the Supreme. Sri Aurobindo came upon the earth from the Supreme to announce the manifestation of a new race and the new world that is supramental. So also we have seen a long, very interesting messages, of course, mother quoted during 16th January 1958. O divine light, supramental reality, with this food, penetrate the whole body, enter into my cell, establish thyself in every atom. May everything become perfectly sincere and receptive, free from all that obstructs the manifestation. In such, open to thee all the parts of my body that are not already thyself. Those parts of my body that does not belong to yourself, you don't possess. Let me open so that everything in entirely, wholeheartedly, entire being, all of my being should be in thy possession, open to thee only. Very interesting topic that we are going to discuss today. So before just we are proceeding forward, the reminiscences of the golden day. So first we'll take the example and the very Dhyumon Das quotation, how he was going to prepare the golden day, golden atmosphere in the ashram. That was the thing we are going to little bit focus upon. Dhyumon says, sweet mother, approaches mother, can we create a golden atmosphere in the in the ashram on 29th February 1960? That was the question, very tricky question. Indirectly or directly, he was ready, his soul is entirely prepared. So he is approaching mother and asking, can we create a golden atmosphere in the ashram on 29th February 1960, which is the first anniversary of the supramental descent, that we know and see he is approaching. The manifestation of the supramental force was a golden light coming down in torrents. Just imagine, that we have already seen. Couple of topics we have already seen, that's torrents. The manifestation of the supramental force was a golden light coming down in torrents. I have a plan, his quotes, I have a plan in my mind to arrange all the things here in an artistic way, just pre-planned. Till then he is going and approaching for the consent of the Supreme Mother. So as to give pleasure to all who came here, we can arrange in all in a golden color. So atmosphere must be golden, already we have quoted upon. So mother, your room, the staircase, the curtains, all, everything should be decorated in golden color. All who come will enjoy this golden divine beauty. Again, another beautiful oblongation, projection. if all who would come will enjoy this golden divine beauty. So newcomers will also get to know the importance of the golden days and supramental manifestation, because many are there still, for them this is almost a next to unknown the concept, supramental manifestation. So new people will come for this darshan, they will have the idea that this golden divine beauty has been manifested upon the atmosphere of the ashram. So they will also get to know the importance of this golden day and the importance, simultaneously, the importance of the supramental manifestation. Then it is from Dimanda, Diman Bhai. Then naturally mother's consent is like this. Mother gave her consent with a radiant smile. Just imagine, divine mother. So her era, everything is coming from area. So divine is approached to give consent for the divine manifestation. Just imagine how it is. So divine mother gave her consent with a radiant smile. She said, her wordings were like, Dhiman, for this we shall have a purchase of some valuable articles of golden color. So for that, for this entire this decoration and all. While a few we can prepare. Some we have to purchase from outside and some we can prepare here also. On that day, 29th February 1960, the ashram was decorated with golden curtains and golden things. Golden pendants with unique symbols were prepared. And on that day, these pendants and messages were distributed by the mother herself to the all persons who were present. These pendants, blessings and messages, it was there. So next we'll see that the beautiful thing, the medal that was offered by mother, given by mother on the golden day, on that day, on 29th February 1960, of course, that was the design of that medal you have seen, the 12 rays of the new creation issued from the manifestation of the avatar. So this has been, we have seen that medal, we have already seen. So the lotus inside that, inside the square itself, there is a lotus, it represents the avatar. The square is there, so this square is manifestation. Lotus is avatar, this square is there, square, inside the square the lotus is there. The square represents the manifestation. 12 rays were there, they are of course new creation. So on that day we have already seen that Sri Krishna came and approached to, and intended to offer blessings on behalf of the mother to the ashramites and the devotees who will come. Mother agreed, it was there. When mother said, when I came down, he was present. Sitting on the laps of the mother, mother's lap, he started distributing the messages to the all the beauty, all the devoted people, devotees and others who were coming for the darshan, have a glimpse. So mother finally quotes, so you see, these gods are independent with their own powers and they are free to do as they like. Already we have known Shiva is interested to come down on earth only with the supramental world. When the earth is ready for the supramental life, he will come, and many others are also there in this thing. The real, in relation with the supramental, there are two irrefutable signs that prove that the relation of the supramental, one is perfect and constant equality. Second, an absolute certainty in the knowledge. So these are the two very irrefutable signs that prove the relation with the supramental. To be perfect, have a little bit of discussion on that. To be perfect, the first one, the equality must be invariable and spontaneous, effortless, towards all circumstances, all happenings, all contacts, matter and material and psychological, and irrespective of their own character and impact. The second one, absolute certainty in the knowledge, and the mother explains it little bit in February 1961. The absolute and indisputable certainty upon infallible knowledge through identity. Knowledge through identity, and before that, knowledge through identity, that proverb infallible is quoted, added by mother. So the thing which are really we are going to know and going to discuss, that is reminiscences of the golden day. In 1960, of course, the words from the Aditi Vasishta. So this was the former student of Sri Aurobindo International Center of Education, Pondicherry. She has a very nice observation on here. In 29th February 1960, the Divine Mother had a grand fast celebration of the Golden Day. Divine Mother had a grand fast celebration of the Golden Day. It was the first anniversary of the Supramental Day. Of course, you know the Supramental Day, the Day of the Lord, we have already known. We children at the ashram were given golden colored frocks. She is quoting. We children, ashram students, given golden colored frocks. A few days before 29th, in the meditation hall, Mother came down and the distribution of that took place. We all stood in line in alphabetically order. Just imagine how the rule, regulation, and how the discipline is there in the ashram. There are three categories, small, medium, and big. Accordingly, it was decorated and designed, and they were standing. I was in the small boys, girls group. My elder sister was in the medium girls, group. There were others who were in the senior girls group. Out of a beautiful golden color cotton cloth, our frocks were made by Sadhanadi, the department. That department for the tailoring and all, Sadhanadi's department is there. Sadhanadi handed over the packets to the Divine Mother, who gave us. The distribution was done by Mother. With us in with a most radiant smile and light in her eyes. Just because this is the everything is golden, everything is supramental. And the Mother smiled also, it is the manifestation of the supramental smile. I received with both hands with mercy bicot, that is a French term, ducomer. The English meaning is there, thanks a lot, sweet Mother. That was the thing, mercy bicot. Doko Mere. Mere means Mother. So on 29th, we wore these frocks that were distributed by the Mother, prepared by in Sadhanandi's department. And in that meditation hall, of course, Mother distributed with radiant smile. The whole ashram looked golden. The elder Sadhikas received white saris with a broad golden colored border. Everything turned golden on that golden day. My Mother wore that. It was the most beautiful and memorable day of our life. This is the reminiscences, whatever we are putting up. There was something special in the air which I can describe in words. Undescribable, simply it is brilliant. Definitely it was beautiful. And there is another quotation from the Mother. It is an exceptional hour. People sleep, they forget. They take life easy. This is the ordinary, as usual quotings given, quoted by Mother. They forget all the time. This is the attitude of people. This is the tendency of the people. But if we could remember that we are at an exceptional hour, this is the thing people forget because these are in ordinary consciousness. But for us it is given a unique time that we have this immense good fortune. This invaluable privilege of being present at the birth of a new world, we could easily get rid of everything that impedes and hinders our progress. Thing is that we have to get prepared. We have to be aware. We have to be prepared. So this thing, with the consent, the inwardness, we have to come forward. This new world is going to burn. So the most important thing, Mother quotes, it seems, is to remember this fact. Even when one does not have the tangible experience, even if he does not have the tangible experience, but he should remember that he should be, there is something that touch is there. So to have the certainty of it and the faith in it, have the certainty of it, that certainty he should, and the faith he must have. To remember always, to recall it constantly, to go to sleep with the idea, to wake up with this perception, this imagine, sleeping and getting up, everywhere the same perception. To do all with one who does the great truth as the in the background, the constant support, and with a great truth that we are witnessing the birth of the new world.